you know, what kind of lessons or what indelible lesson do you think that your dad has taught you as a mentor that when he's long gone and retired, you know, what would you be sitting at the head of the board of the table and pontificate about, you know, what your dad had taught you and a lesson that's remained true to this time? I know I can, things pop into my head about my dad and about my mentor now that, you know, about, you know, face-to-face meetings over, you know, phone calls and texts and those types of things where you, every time we get on an airplane and go meet somebody, I'm always like, you know, that was a lot of work, but it was definitely worth sitting down across from somebody, like those types of lessons. I'm curious if there's like anything that comes to the forefront of your mind like that.
Yeah. So a lot of the stuff that we talked about, I would say how we run our business, how we treat our people, family spirit, giving back, all of that is 100% probably the highest thing that comes to mind. But I think I'd probably say the hard work, he still goes to all the furniture markets. He yep. still travels. He's like itching.
You're talking about like in China and stuff, right?
Oh, yeah.
He's around the world.
He's itching to get back on a plane and just start traveling the world and looking for deals and product and new merchandising strategies. So that was really important. I mean, I can't underscore that. Like, when I came out of college, I traveled on weekends. I visited different businesses. I obviously went with him to Asia or wherever the furniture world was at, you know, US, you name it. And I think that travel, that constant learning, that constant being on the forefront of the industry, I know he doesn't like not, you know, staying put. And I think that really has rubbed off on me. And I became whatever I was trying to learn. You know, I didn't try to learn from my desk or my computer or my house. You know, I was very visible. I travel a lot, learn from everybody, million mentors. And I don't know how that just doesn't make you super, super, super smart, you know? And
yeah.
And that is, he's a smart guy, but that made him, you know, our industry's best because he took that extra time to travel and, you know, talk to a sales associate in a store in Milwaukee and learn about what they're doing there. You know, he is a constant learner. So I think that's the first thing that comes to mind.
Yeah, I love that. Yeah, there's just no substitute, right, for that in-person, face-to-face experience. And as much as I think business will change and continue to evolve, I don't know that that will ever change, right?
We'll still be traveling. We'll still be everywhere. We just might be more mobile. So he's like, he's working half his mornings at home and coming in a little bit later. Great. You know, and now, he's still going to travel all around the world. So.
Right.